So now I'm walking from the house down towards the river. I'm at FH5 lower property down by the river. It's pretty nice. A lot of fruit trees planted, bananas and citrus and stuff like that. Yeah. Now we're walking from the house, which is over there, out into the pasture here, through the back. We're walking in the east direction, and up there you can see the hill. When we get through the trees, up that hill is FH6, and past that FH3. You can see all the pasture on this property, it's pretty nice. And now we're walking towards the ponds they have over here. Here there's a couple coconut palms growing. Here's another pasture area. There's a dip and there's a stream, and then about 50 meters past that stream is the property boundary to the north. Here there's two more outbuildings. This property probably has like 10 outbuildings. Of course they're not in that great shape, but they're also not falling apart either. Here's a fish pond covered in a net where they're probably currently producing tilapia. ¿Tiene pescado ahorita?
Sí. Ah, yeah. Ya están los tilapias.
Tilapia, sí.
Sí. Me queda la comida.
Ah, tiene muchísimo.
Sí. Y ahorita están tímidos. Ya. Yeah.
Alright, I just came from the fish pond near those two outbuildings over there. You can see the top of the ridge there, just past that is the FH6, and also the FH3 just past that, which I also posted photos and videos of. And now we're heading back towards the Rio Zamora in the west direction. I'm gonna go down this little slope, then I'm gonna cross the stream, and then we're gonna go back out onto the public path, where I'll take another video on the way out. Another video clip, rather. I gotta figure out how to cross here. This isn't really the path I was supposed to go on. Here's a stream. Let's see if I can get across it. Yeah, I made it. Alright, there's a few outbuildings, and then past that is the house, which I took more photos than videos. So on the photos link, you can see a whole bunch of photos of the outside of the house. I didn't go inside the house. There's a family living there right now, but the inside is basically what you see on the outside. It's just a typical post and beam wood construction. About some of the roof is clay tile and some of the roof is metal. Yeah. Two stories, a lot of bedrooms. He said like 5 bedrooms, a kitchen, dining room area. I'm on the path out heading towards the public path, and there's some banana trees and various other things. Walking back to this plantation area right near the river where they're about to plant a bunch of papayas. The public path kind of ends here, but before this it went straight through here, and there was a little bridge that crossed the stream. Kept going all the way to the community, the village San Carlos, which is just up the river. And the bridge fell into disrepair, and then they don't really use the path anymore, but if we bought the property, we'd probably throw up a little bridge there and open the path again, because the people would appreciate that. I know they've been trying to get the path reopened again, but they don't necessarily have the money to get those things going. So I'm walking on the public path right now in the north direction, back towards FH2 and FH1. And on either side of me is mostly overgrown. You saw probably a bunch of pictures of just overgrown brush. Most of those pictures were taken here on either side of the path. And it used to be like a lot of sugarcane and papayas and things, but there used to be a lot more agricultural activity on this farm, but the owner, as he was getting older and older, and he has other businesses, and he wasn't putting as much TLC into the farm, so that's why, for example, the outbuildings that you saw the pictures of, which were obviously pig stalls, there's nothing in them. So the only animals really being raised here are the fish and the cow pastures just being rented out to whoever owns the herd of cows. So it's actually kind of nice that the amount of animal agriculture has gone down and down, but there probably also used to be a lot more bananas and papayas and things, but they still have a good amount. You can see the bananas all the way around the edge here. And just about across the property boundary, which is marked by this big tree and kind of where the forest starts here. So right now I'm looking towards the river, and now I'm looking towards the property boundary, and just now stepping out of the Freehaven 5 property just past the northern boundary. Now I'm back in the property that's labeled Fruithaven 4, which we also have not purchased yet, but may in the future. Anyway, so that's all for this property walkthrough video, which was of the Fruithaven 5 property, which is being sold along with FH6. We're negotiating with the owners, trying to find people to buy it up front so we can turn it into a raw vegan community land where people get personal homestead lots, and we also develop a community area, which will likely be where the current house is, big house. If you're interested in more information, go to fruithavenecovillage.com and click on group land buys at the link at the top, and you can send us an email. Email's on the website. Let us know you're interested, and if you have a Facebook profile, we can add you to the Facebook secret group where we post a lot of updates and other things. But don't worry if you don't use Facebook, that's okay, because we still post all the really important updates on the actual page. And we'll hopefully be opening web portals in the future that don't rely on Facebook to relay information to people. That'll be all. Oh, and make sure you subscribe to the channel.